What does Christmas mean to you? And what do you think Christmas meant to those people who first witnessed the birth of Jesus? My name is Ernest Wamboe, and you are watching Sitam Church Online. The Bible says in the book of Luke, chapter 2, from verse 8 to 20, it's a story of the shepherds who were actually given the news by the angels concerning the birth of Jesus. And I'm going to read what it says, and then I'm going to explain what it means. This is what it says. Luke 2, verse 8. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. Verse 9. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. Verse 10. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord." Verse 12, "This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Verse 13, "Suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared to the angel, praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests.' When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, 'Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.'" Whenever I'd read that passage concerning the shepherds, I used to wonder, why would the angels appear to some random shepherds and give them the good news concerning the arrival of Jesus Christ on earth? Why would they want to hear that? It wasn't until I understood the context of this message. I found out that the shepherds in Bethlehem would actually graze their flocks in a place called Midgal Eder. Now, Midgal Eder was a very special location for Israel. Why? People would come to Midgal Eder and then proceed to Jerusalem for a particular reason. At Midgal Eder, the sheep would be reared and they would be kept for a particular purpose during the Feast of Atonement and during the sacrifice for the sins of the people by the high priest. The sheep that were put aside at Midgal Eder by the shepherds were sheep that were blameless, sheep that had no spots, no wrinkle, sheep that had no deformities, sheep that were perfect. And they were taken as lambs from their mothers, and when they were newly born, they were wrapped in clothes so that no harm would come on them, and they would be placed in a manger, and they would be kept away. And whenever people would want to buy an animal for sacrifice, they would come to Midgal Eder, they would ask the shepherds for a sheep, and the sheep would look for one of the sheep in a manger that was perfect, pure, blameless, without defect, and they would give it to this person. This person would then take that sheep, go to Jerusalem, offer it to the high priest, and the high priest would slaughter that sheep to take care of the sins of the people or the sins of the person who had offered it. Now, when the shepherds appear, when the angels appear to the shepherds in the field, they tell them that a Savior has been born. But there's something specific that they say. They say that this will be a sign to you, that this baby who has been born will be wrapped in clothes and will be lying in a manger. Now, that must have meant something to the shepherds. To us, it may not have meant something, but for those shepherds who worked at Midgal Eder, that must have been very, very, very astounding. Why would a baby be wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger? That's the way we do with the new sheep that are born for sacrifice. And so they rushed off to see Mary and Joseph, and surely when they got there, they found Jesus wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. The moment the shepherds saw Jesus Christ lying in a manger, immediately they must have been reminded of their sheep back in Midgal Eder that were normally wrapped in clothes, lying in a manger, and later taken for the sacrifice of the sins of the people. Right there at the birth of Jesus, the Lord was giving the shepherds a glimpse of the death of Jesus. Right there in Midgal Eder, the sheep that was sacrificed reminded the shepherds that Jesus Christ may be that same Lamb of God who would be sacrificed one day, and not just for the sins of a few people, but for the sins of the whole world. Just as the sheep in Midgal Eder were kept away, they were perfect, they were blameless, without deformity, so was Christ kept away, perfect, blameless, without sin. He was without deformity. and he was kept in that manger, and at the right time he would be taken out of that manger and he would be slaughtered for the sins of the people. That is exactly what happened to Christ 33 years after his death. He hung on that cross and he was slaughtered for the sins of the people. When the shepherds saw the resurrection of Jesus Christ, when they saw the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, they must have remembered his death. They must have remembered his birth. They must have remembered that his birth was prophesying his death that would come for the sins of the people. Now you must understand that this means something for you. That Christmas is not just about the eating and the drinking. Christmas had a purpose, that when Christ was born, God was thinking about the end in mind, the salvation of his people. God was thinking about your salvation. God was thinking about your redemption. And that is why the angel told the shepherds, "I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people." The question is, have you experienced your Midgal Eder? Have you experienced the sheep, the Lamb of God, wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger, who will one day be sacrificed for your sins? And in our case, who was sacrificed for our sins. There's a reason to be grateful, despite what you're going through, that your sins have been forgiven if you turn and repent and surrender to the Lamb of God. Thank you very much for watching this video. I pray it has blessed you. I pray it has enlightened you. If it has done so, please leave a like. Please leave a comment. Let us know what you think and share it with your friends. And if you'd like to join us for our church services, you're welcome to come to Seaton Valley Road every Sunday. We've got 2 services. Feel free, feel at home, and we'll be sure to host you. My name is Ernest Wamboe, and you're watching Seaton Church Online.